Hygge isn't about making a space cozy. It's about making your mind cozy. It's about evoking a feeling. And I felt something unexpected. This is how bringing the hygge concept into my life unexpectedly taught me how to better love myself. I'm someone who's pretty affected by the space I'm in. I find it difficult to get tasks done, and sometimes even to think straight if there's visual clutter or if I'm in a space that doesn't feel inviting. So I've intentionally made my home a tidy, cozy, warm and welcoming place. And this is in part due to the implementation of hygge. Some people describe hygge as finding pleasure and comfort in everyday things. It's an intentional practice for cultivating those moments, choosing to see things in this way to promote well-being and happiness. And it's especially useful in the colder months. So I started with looking at my space and deciding whether it's a space I genuinely want to spend time in. The first thing I want to mention is that bringing cozy and homely things into your space doesn't mean spending money on decor. Everything I own except my mattress and washing machine is secondhand or gifted, as I found that not only is it cheaper and better for the environment, but I can find and breathe new life into the most unique and beautiful pieces this way. Making your own decor, like the basket I'm making in this video, is also deeply gratifying. There's something wonderful about owning items that have a story and seem to have lived themselves. It allows us to embrace and even beautify what we'd usually deem as imperfections. The most hygge league suggestion is usually to create a cozy nook, but if you don't have an area of your house to dedicate, adding blankets and pillows to your lounge and chairs can make those spaces you already relax in feel even more inviting. And this is the way I chose to bring this idea into my home. The element I was most excited about was adding warm lighting to my space. I already have a lamp I love to use to read under or have on when we're winding down for the night, but I had candles stashed away that I wanted to get more use out of. A fun tip is putting your lighting sources at different heights to create glow spaces at different levels in the house. Using this warm and dim lighting creates a calm and soothing space, which made me want to reach for relaxing activities like colouring in, writing letters, reading, or making something with my hands, like macrame or basket weaving. And this is perfect, because reaching for tactile and slow living activities is also a part of the hygge concept. A sense that is often forgotten is our sense of smell. Bringing homely scents into a space is a small but effective detail for creating a hygge atmosphere. I like the use of scented candles or essential oils for smells that feel homely and are associated with autumn, like cinnamon, apple pie, maple syrup, or pine needles. Even though these smells aren't the smell of home per se, they give off that cozy, nurturing feeling that I feel a home should embody. For summer days, fresh smells like peppermint are perfect for a combination of homely and alive. If you have other smells that would ignite that feeling of home, find a way to bring those into your space more regularly. An idea for this that may be overlooked is the smell of a home-cooked meal. There's nothing more comforting than coming home and smelling a warm meal cooking in the kitchen. For the colder months especially, I found it very hygge to make the time I had in the afternoons and evenings a little more extra, with a hot chocolate, a cup of tea, or even something super extra, like an Epsom salt foot bath. Or a real bath if you have one. It gives you the perfect time to indulge a little more than usual and be present in the moment. The next, and possibly the most important suggestion, is to maintain a tidy space. This one seems tedious, and the achievability of it is going to vary depending on how many people live with you and whether there are kids in the house. So something I've implemented is, when you're leaving a room, take 2 to 3 items that don't belong in that room, but do belong in the room you're going to, with you, and put them away. Other small details, like tucking away cords and closing drawers and cupboard doors all the way, can often mean the difference between a space that feels lived in and a space that feels untidy. Doing these small, simple acts has made a big difference in the time it takes to tidy when I'm dedicating a chunk of time to it, and it makes my space feel generally clutter-free in between those proper tidy sessions. The purpose of this is to keep the focus on the beautiful things you like to look at that you've intentionally placed in your space. Hygge embraces the concept of indulging in the life you have, and one brilliant way of doing that is enjoying hearty food like pastries, cakes, and warm soup with the people you love. This is a really integral part to hygge, and I'm so glad it stayed attached to the meaning, because the word hygge has been traced back to the Middle Ages, where it meant protected from the outside world, presumably tucked away with your tribe or family for safety and comfort. And I think it's an intrinsic desire within us to be sat around a glowing light like a fire with our friends and family, telling stories and feeling grateful for this very moment. The modern meaning of the word, often used synonymously with cozy, has also been described as socializing for introverts, which, as an introvert, just feels like I'm somehow being understood. My last suggestion is to consciously enjoy your day off. Intentionally create a work-life balance that truly works for you. If you want to be the type of person that goes for walks or reads books or has relaxing hobbies, allow yourself the weekend and afternoons to do those things. Learn to play guitar or knit or draw. Spend Sunday afternoons in bed, watching movies and eating popcorn. Hygge is about getting immersed. Choose to be overjoyed by the simple things, like the taste of your hot chocolate, the scent of your pinecone scented candle, the warmth of your cozy blanket, and more often than not, you'll find that you really are. You just maybe rarely let the feeling come through. When I'm doing hygge stuff, like the ordinary things I've mentioned, I'm doing things with intention. I'm immersed in the life I have and the things that are already present in my life. I don't feel pressured to have more or to have achieved more. I don't feel pressured to be more of something. I'm not worried about how I'm being perceived. Adapting to a mindset that makes it easier for me to be content with my moment-to-moment life also makes it easier for me to accept who I am on a moment-to-moment basis within this life. There's a famous quote about turning people into trees by Ram Dass that goes, "When you go out into the woods and you look at trees, you see all these different trees. And some of them are bent, and some of them are straight, and some of them are evergreens, and some of them are whatever. And you look at the tree and you allow it. You see why it is the way it is. You sort of understand that it didn't get enough light and so it turned that way. And you don't get all emotional about it. You just allow it. You appreciate the tree. The minute you get near humans, you lose all that. And you're constantly saying, you're to this or I'm to this. That judgment mind comes in. And so I practice turning people into trees, which means appreciating them just the way they are." And we should apply this also to how we view ourselves. There are so many triggers for self-comparison today, especially when you go on TikTok or Instagram and you have no idea what you're going to see next in your feed. And this comes from a really normal instinct to fit in. But I want you to know that you don't always have to opt into that world. You're allowed to choose not to stay up to date, unplug from the insistent stream of information at your fingertips, and instead, opt to simply be present in the life that surrounds you.